my experience in Australia was cut way short, and I want to have that second chance at my dream of getting to the end. The Angkor Wat temples, that's a total metaphor for this whole game, because you know, you get a little bit of damage, but you know what, you can build yourself up. 14 years is a long time to finish that last chapter in the book.
Our first challenge is going to be the very first survivor challenge on the very first survivor. And to be able to get the first tree mail after waiting so long, it's, you know, you get those little butterflies in your stomach.
There's that superficial fun and harmony, I think. Everybody's just trying to take it day by day because we haven't had to make the decisions of voting somebody out. But underneath, I think there's a lot of scrambling going on. But, you know, for while we have it, we're just going to keep enjoying the peace. I mean, having a second chance at this is phenomenal. I think I'm known for being a little bit outspoken. I'm the same person, but I'm just at a different place in my life. Now when I speak my mind, I'm a little bit more reserved. I try not to make waves, and I feel like I'm doing well this time. So we'll just have to see. I'm hoping that I go far. Jeff threw a monkey wrench in my operation, and he split us all up, but I'm okay with it. But I'm always surprised that the swap happened so early. When I see Angkor, you know, you feel badly because that could have been any one of us going over there. So you have that, you know, compassion for them. But in the name of the game, guess what? Every day you vote somebody out is another day longer I'm here. I really need to practice my patience a little bit more because Monica is wearing my patience very thin.
A bird in the hand is worth more than two in the bush. I mean, doesn't she know these things? I just...
She's like, oh, leave them in the ocean, leave them in the ocean.
Oh, God.
We need to eat.
We don't need to eat food. No, just leave it back in the ocean because we're going to go and deplete the whole entire ocean of its supply of food.
No pumpkin, no.
You know what? If my biggest problem out here is Monica, then I'm doing okay. Instead of me being so emotional in my reactions, I try not to make waves. I just have to remember self-control. I'm older and wiser, but I'm not used to having somebody else giving me their opinion where it's not welcome. We have four original Bayon, and these are our roots. Now, all of a sudden, Monica is looking for an old girl's thing. I have no idea where that girl's going, and she's gonna ruin a really good thing.
We four just have to stay short.
Done. 100%.
That's it. Monica playing Survivor, she's just a liability because she's a loose cannon, and she'd be a flipper.
She's a snake in the grass.
Yeah.
She's a snake in the grass.
My whole entire ambition is to get to the end. And there are gonna be casualties. Monica is not playing for the Bayon tribe. Monica is playing for Monica. And she will go and step on every single one of us thinking like she owns us. And you know what? The joke's gonna be on her.
The first time I played in Australia, I was only out here for 15 days and did not make the merge. So making the merge is like, yes, yay! I'm doing a happy dance on the inside and on the outside because I made the merge. My second chance has been a huge success. Being able to reflect and learn and say, hey, you know what? You were being a smart mouth kid back then. Be a little bit more patient, listen a little bit more, ask a few more questions. I think that has definitely helped me to further my game, and I'm very proud of myself for getting, you know, farther this time than I did, and now I just have a little bit farther to go.
I was so super excited. It was my first time ever going on a reward with food either season, so it was so super special for me. It was nice to get just a little glimpse of what life is like outside the game for just a little while.
Joe won immunity, which is fine because I really need the witches to start getting voted out because I don't want them getting too much power.
My older son has kidney disease, and when you sit and you put things into perspective, if he could do that, then I can certainly endure these elements of Survivor because all my strength for being out here comes from my boys.
When Jeff gave us the white and black rock, you know, our heads were all spinning. What could this be? Jeff has something up his sleeve. After tribal, I felt completely blindsided, and I realized I need to be in control of my destiny.
So we get rid of Joe. That's four women. And then girls have an upper hand.
I didn't come out here and leave my family just to be somebody's pawn. I came out here to win. So it's time for me to make my move. All of us that had parents here got to go and enjoy a picnic, and Keith Nail got to have his wife. I think like the more long-term relationships got it, and I think it was a good choice. Having confirmation from my daddy that the boys are great at Grammy and Pop Pops, everything's wonderful. It's like, okay, my boys are in great hands. I can go and I can play this game and finish this out because the weight of the worry is gone. Honestly, Wentworth and I, if the two other girls were on board, we could have an all-girl alliance and do this, and I don't understand what the problem is. Joe has to go. Me getting my loved one visit with my dad blows away any other reward that could come up. So when Wentworth called me, it was like all the gameplay that, you know, of writing each other's name down, and that didn't matter. Me and Wentworth combined in our first games that we played have 27 days of playing, and here we are doing well in our own games. So it would be sweet, sweet justice if Wentworth and I could be down at the end pleading our case and saying, hey jury, look what we did. Right now I'm gonna go full force because I wanna go out of here with a bang. From the outside, Wentworth and Keith look like they're low men on the totem pole, but this has just now left me with the perfect opportunity to swoop in and make my dreams happen. I came out here to win this thing. And if I go with Tosh, Jeremy, and Spencer, am I really gonna make it to the end? That's putting my fate and destiny into somebody else's hands. These guys trust me. They're letting the guard down, and now's my chance to shine. You know, 15 years out of the game, I still got this.
Oh my gosh, I would never go and turn on you guys. We're together.
I mean, come on. I don't want to be on the bottom of a foursome. And that's where I am with Spencer and Jeremy and Tasha. I'm not stupid.